Hello everyone, my name is Daku Ciro and in today's video we are going to highlight Jacqueline Vot, who's a Romanian streamer. And as you can see, she's playing on Ensk encounter map using an tier 8 German light premium light tank, M41 90mm grand final, which is a really amazing scout tank at tier 8 and a really good money maker tank, I would say, because you can do a lot of stuff with this tank. It's fast, you have really decent DPM, and yeah, you have everything what you would ask from a tier 8 premium tank. Alright, let's get started, let's see what's going to happen in the following seconds. As you can see, the first action on Ensk map was to take the rail lines as really fast, really as fast as possible, because you really want to spot the what's happening in the map, what position on the enemy is going to take. And because of taking this position, actually Jackie saw that saw where the enemy went, on where the majority of the enemy were. So just by going there on the middle, she actually realized that in the city side there are only a few tanks, and only STRV was spotted crossing. They probably there are a couple more, one or two, but they weren't spotted. So she took a decision that it would be good to go and kill that tier 6 STRV 74, which is really nicely done, and nothing to say about it more. Looks like the STRV is bouncing the M41 90mm, which is really amazing. I don't know, a tier 6 medium Swedish tank can't paint a tier 8, which yeah, it's kind of weird, I would say. She only take one shot from the enemy STRV for now, and but the STRV is already dead. So, and next action is to what Arty was spotted, and she took a really nice shot on Arty as well as on the VK 2000 and 2D, and she's trying to do it again, but instead she spotted the E25, which is more dangerous than the VK, and she took a really nice shot on the E25. And now she could have tried to shoot the E25, which is which she already did. A lot of the enemy were trying to rush back to their spawn, because they saw that they were attacking from the back and they were trying to defend, but as you can see, it's really sadly for them. Two of them are already dead, E25 and MX 12 tons. They are really unfortunate. And that VK is still taking a lot of shots, and he's doing apparently nothing too significant back. He shot once, but he took more than more shot back, and yep, looks like he managed to kill the MX. And now the Jack is kind of in trouble, because she's alone for now, but looks like there is a WZ 131 coming to aid her, and they are going together and trying to focus to go for another direction, because this is a normal and natural thing to do. You can't stay in multiple line of fire, and then you're going to read that what happened to the flight, you lose so many HP and so on. So sometimes it's just better to change the position and try to flank them and try to shoot for a better position. Sadly, Jackie took a really bad shot, almost 300 damage to the high explosive from the enemy VK, but the VK was taken off of the combat, which is really good. 4 kills already, which is really amazing for the moment. Especially in an ace map, while you play tier 8 light tank, it's not easy with a light tank on a city map to try to prove yourself too much, because you have to move a lot and try to use whatever bushes or cover do you have. And right here was a really nice shot against that WZ, really amazing. And I don't know with the second shot what happened, apparently it hit something, I don't know, a car or some destructible structure, but bad. And now she took a shot from the WZ 132, which is not that good, but looks like the other WZ has push up and trying to kill her, but unfortunate, Jackie shot first. Unfortunate for the WZ, Jackie shot first and took it out from the combat. Right now, this was really kind of trouble, because she took two shots without expecting it. But it's no trouble, she fall back just in time to avoid a disaster, and now he's waiting for that Thunderbolt to make a mistake and try to shoot at him, and yeah, that also happened. The Thunderbolt took a free shot, but it's quite amazing how the Thunderbolt managed to spot her to this lot of bushes and with the camo involved, but I guess it was not view range, it was really close. Really close quarters, she was really close to the Thunderbolt, so that's why he spotted her. But also, she was really lucky. This is the second time when Art is shooting after her, and Art still didn't manage to connect the battle, which is really bad for Art, but it's really good for our hero in the video. Right now, again in trouble, because 88 is really dangerous, and also coming with full HP, but he doesn't know that he can be flanked so easy, and he can take a lot of shots. If you get in flank, he's most probably going to die. But now, as you can see, the best thing to do is try to do as much damage as possible. But just because the Jack managed to track him, she's going to try to take it out, I'm pretty sure about that. Because there's no point to let low HP targets still alive, because they are going to kill you later. They are going to kill you later if you don't pay attention to that. And again, really lucky. Because that OI just took a shot, and the shot landed just before our tank. And even Arty shot and only managed to do a stun effect, which is really amazing and really lucky. But as far as you can see, she did already 9 kills, which is amazing so far. And yeah, she knows that T29 is capping the base, and Arty is on the last position spotted, because they can be on the other side. All should have known that. And right now it's a really interesting tactic, trying to be really cheeky and sneaky, which is really good. You can go up in the open and try to shoot your gun blazing and then expect to win every single battle. You have to use tactic, you have to use building cover, anything you can get, even bushes and so on. Two shots on T29, which was full HP, is really really good. And we have to remember that Jack is low HP, only one shot with high explosive, even a scratch or a shot from that can take her out. And right now, a really nice decision was made, trying to change the flank and going to the other way as far as possible for the enemy, so you can shoot without getting spotted. But then Arty was spotted and was taken out from the combat really nicely. And she waited a few seconds to see if actually Arty is going to spot her or not. And looks like Arty did spot it, probably a bad rage or something, so bad crew, we don't know. And but we don't care about that. And again, T28, which is really dangerous. And she's down now to 4 high explosive shots, which is really not good. Because high explosive is not an ammo that is too reliable. Even if you hit paper armor, you can still fail, do low damage, or even fail to do damage at all. So high explosive is not so reliable. But she managed to connect another shot against that T28 that is capping the base. And again, as you can see, is changing again the direction, so the enemy doesn't know exactly where she's going to show up. And this is checking the corner, which is really nicely done. That was insane, checking the corner. It's quite important to check sometimes the corner, but again, at the same time, sometimes if you stop just before the corner, the enemy might aim there, and you can take a bad hit from him. So that tactic sometimes works, sometimes not. So yeah, it's all about luck sometimes, or how good the enemy skill is. And Right now, she thought that the enemy is going to chase her because the cap went off, and that only means one thing, that the 329 was getting out of the cap and trying to search for her. But he noticed that 329 noticed that she wasn't there no more, so then he decided to go back to the base. But in this case, 329 is doing a bad thing because he's letting know Jackie that he's staying in the same spot. Jackie knows that he's just waiting there in the cap, and he can be flanked, he can be outplayed, but of course it's not easy, because if you get exactly in the place that the enemy is aiming, you are in trouble, you can die really fast. And here is the moment when I see that high explosive ammo is not that reliable. She shot the turret of the enemy T29, and really nothing happened, which is really bad. But again falling back from the combat, because especially when you're low HP, you don't want to be there, and you don't want to be fight face to face. You want to be sneaky, you want to use the range, you want to use all the cover you can get in order to hit the enemy, to do damage, and try to win the game, because this is all about the game. You have to win, and you also have to perform really well, especially at this level. So let's see what's going to happen next. Then right there, T29 was spotted, and I guess the game is pretty much over. Really nice last shot with high explosive on the F's, and GG. Okay, let's see the post-game stats. Alright, so in this battle she managed to get an ace tank, a really well-deserved Kolobanov medal, as well as pool medal, and defender, high caliber, and top gun as well. An really huge amount of base experience of 1857 base experience, which is really enormous, I would say. But yeah, at this kind of level, what can you expect? And there you go, 44 shots fired with 39 shell hits the target, and 33 shell penetrating the target, 6123 damage done, and with the decap on the base, which you can see it's 100%, which is really amazing. Not too much money made at this point, because there were some shots fired with the hit ammo, which wasn't okay if you want to farm money. But yeah, again, congratulations for the Kolobanov medal, and also for the pool medal, because they are not so easy medal to get. And again, thank you everyone for watching, and